All right, hello everyone, and welcome to our session, Clicks Not Cash, Streamlining Rent Collections. I'm Dustin Daly from the Yardi Breeze team, and will be moderating this session today. According to a renter's preference survey, more than 92% of renters consider online rent payments an important resident portal feature. However, a Rent Cafe survey found that only 42% of renters say they have access to an online resident portal. As a property management software provider, Yardi's partnered with thousands of independent rental owners over the years, and one common theme comes up with all operators. It's streamlining rent collections. As many of you know, it's rare to see a standardized method of rent payment. It's usually a combination of online payments, checks, money orders, bank transfers, Venmo, credit cards, debit cards, sometimes even cash. This can be a tedious process to oversee with many risks. Whether you're considering adopting online payments for the first time, or if you've already implemented a resident portal and are looking to optimize and increase resident adoption, we think this session will be of value to help you further streamline this process every month. Joining with me today to share her story is Urvashi Foster, owner and operator of Georgetown Apartments based in Georgetown, Georgia, under God and God Alone LLC. Urvashi, thanks so much for joining us today. Would you mind giving us a brief introduction about yourself and your business?
Hi, everybody. My name is Urvashi Foster. I am, like Justin said, in Georgetown, Georgia. I have 50 doors. Georgetown Apartments is one property. I started it in 2018. I am a true IRO. That's it.
Well, great. Thanks so much for being here today. Kind of curious, in 2018, I want to hear about, you know, a critical part of your business, rent collection. Can you tell us, like, in those first few months, like, can you paint the picture and, you know, how did you use to collect rent?
It was cash first, money orders, checks. Those were the only options. Some of them would mail it, and we would not get it much later in the month. But I live in a small town in a rural area. My property is right behind my house. So on the 5th, when the rent is due, at 12 at night, people are knocking on my door to pay the rent, so they won't have to pay the late fee. That's how I started.
Wow. So actual cash and in person, not to an office, but they're living close by you, right?
So, yes, they are right behind me.
So sure, some risk come along with that. How many units are right around your area? You say you manage 50, but how many were right there?
24 units right behind my house. Okay. And it did have its own challenges. Risk, cash, notes, whatnot, collecting cash home, another risk. Checks, non-sufficient funds. You don't know, until like 5-7 days later that they did not have. Then you have to go collect late fees, non-sufficient fund. You have to give the notices. You have to go to their house, give the notice. Not just that, to go to mailbox to see if they paid you in mail. They would say they put it in a mail and it would not come for so long. After all that collection, you had to manually make a deposit slip, take it to bank, and you can imagine 50, either money order check or cash, you have to do balance and all that and then take it to bank. And so many time, it would take so long for bank to process all those money orders and checks. And they would make mistakes in punching a number because their system would not pick up money order written figure. If it says $250.63, sometime it would just pick up $25. So they have made mistakes. And then you have to stand there and fix. But those are the problems by collecting. in person.
Yeah, certainly sounds like risks there, and also a tedious process of, opening up the mail and opening up checks, depositing to the bank. Are you also like then, were you manually entering in those receipts into, a spreadsheet or your accounting system at the end of the month?
Yes, it was a spreadsheet. And yes, at the end of a month, you would have to do the accounting, and you have to issue the receipts also, if because they were paying cash. So we had to give the, receipts. Sometime mail it, sometime they would just request. And yeah, so all that plus some more.
I'm sure. And so you said you took over management in 2018. Can you remember back when was it where you decided to adopt an online payment system, and then and why? Where did you hit a tipping point? Why did you where did you decide it was time to change?
My daughter, definitely much younger than me. She was home. She is in Air Force. She was home, and the people were bringing, like I said, cash, money order, whatnot. And she's like, "Mom, this is 2020, something. Yeah, 2020. We have to do online. There are so many softwares out there. There is so many. It makes your life easy. You don't have to have so many things to do, and you can invest your time somewhere else." Definitely was not thrilled, but I knew I needed help because it was just getting out of a hand to manage when they don't. It was getting few months behind. Like if they say it was in a mail, and if it did not come in a mail, next month is right around the corner. If they paid late, like 20th, if they paid, and the mail did not come until 5th, we are now in 2 months, and you can't, imagine. It's so that's when I got a help with my daughter. She did the basic setting up online, and it went really smooth, to my surprise.
Yeah. Well, did you have hesitations going into this change here?
Oh, like 3, 4 months, she kept asking me, and absolutely, because I was set in my own ways. And the people, because I do live in a rural area where my clientele is much older, and they don't have as much technology available to them, or not familiar with technology. So absolutely, the biggest problem I saw in my head that my clients would not like it, and they would all leave me and go somewhere else, or it would create more problem. But to my surprise, after a few months, first few months, they all were on board, and they all were much happier.
That's incredible. Sounds like you had, you mentioned some help, motivation from your daughter, and also, software provider to help, give you those tools. Can you just talk a little bit more about that, those 3 to 4 months, that change? Were you working with residents and explaining the new technology, or how did the actual change happen within that time frame?
So the first we when we registered, or when we signed up with the software, we sent everybody notice that we are going online. This is the platform we are going to accept the payment. It was first few months, everybody was not on board, but then we sent that, okay, this is the way we are going to do. After technology, my daughter got on a phone with certain people, the people who needed help, then certain older people, we got their grandkids involved in downloading the app. We got some time support from the app people, that they helped understanding difference between ACH payment, credit card, debit card, how the fees varies and whatnot. So after 4 months, I would say 99% people were online, but it took a little bit, and we had to, the people who did not sign up, we had to go ask them what is the hesitation, why not, what is it that worries them. Some of them had the worry of security because it was a different platform and bank was connected to that. So that's where the app representative helped make sure that they felt secure enough. When the technology, if they did not know how and where, so all in all, it went good after 4 months.
Yeah, that's definitely the transition, but it's very impressive to hear a 99% adoption rate. That's tremendous. That's certainly higher than the industry average when companies get the portal up and running. So
I
again,
have one. Yeah.
except for one, yeah. So
Except
who's the one?
one.
What's
I
that?
have
What's the story
one.
there?
She is 80 some years old, 80 some. I don't know the exact age, but she's set in her ways. We have been doing business with her for a while before I purchased. And she's like, it's not broke. Why change? Okay. So she still just does the way she has been doing it. So that's the only one. Everybody else
Absolutely.
is on board.
With new technology, there's always going to be an exception here or there, but at least, getting one check to manually process compared to 50
Take
is
it any
definitely
day.
streamlined, right? So yeah, night
Yes.
and day. And I heard you mention, you have residents that are adopted and they're paying online. You mentioned there's different payment methods that are possible.
Yes.
I heard you mention like ACH from their bank account. I heard you say credit cards. Do you have like a rough percentage of what are residents paying? Are they using credit card? Are they using their bank accounts? What are you seeing there?
It's definitely more credit card. I have definitely more credit card processing than ACH because it helps them if their paycheck did not fall on that week or if they did not have the money, they can still pay with the credit card and don't have to pay the late fees and they can manage their credit card afterwards. And that is the benefit that majority of the people did not have when I was collecting manual payments.
Oh, that's interesting. I'm sure it also depends on, the resident demographic, if they prefer to ha have credit cards or want to pay by bank. But giving them
Yeah,
options, it sounds like
absolutely.
is a nice thing, right?
And then, residents who are conservative, who wants to just spend a dollar like they used to on a money order, they would connect ACH, but the younger generation who wants to get the points or who wants the flexibility, then they go for credit cards.
Yeah. And that's interesting. That's something that at Yardi on the software side, we're hearing a lot from operators and from residents is the need for like renter rewards and, getting points by paying rent, whether it's by credit card or maybe even by bank account, or giving them flexible rent payment options. These are things that we're thinking about and working with other companies on as we evolve our software, just based on new demographics. What's Gen Z doing? How are they paying their rent? And what credit cards do they have? So really interesting to hear some insights there. You also mentioned money orders and cash. So were there any residents that like don't have bank accounts and credit cards? Did you think do something like a walk-in payment system?
Yes, we had one or two, and the app did provide where they can go to a local convenience store, gas station, Walmart, where they can pay the cash and it will deposit in their account on the software.
I see. Well, that's a great option if, because sometimes that could be the objection, right? Well, I don't have a bank account. I want to pay in cash. Well, hey, you can do this in a more secure way at one of the retailers that are probably also down the street. Instead of your place, it could be down the street at a 7-Eleven,
Absolutely.
right? So
Yes.
Great. I was curious, right? You mentioned, a bit of a process, right? 3 to 4 months to really, convert all of your residents to get that 99% adoption rate. But what about new residents moving in? What's the process of getting them onboarded?
So we use the software for an application as well, and that's where they start. So as soon as they contact us that they are interested in renting a unit, we send them application through the software. So they are already aware of the platform. As soon as their application and their software processes the application as well. Once the software processes, then I can accept, decline, or ask for guarantor information. And everything is online. So that makes it also very easy because before I used to have to get the application, either it may be paper or another way, and then process it. But this way it streamlines, and the tenant already is aware as soon as they are accepted for for the unit, we send them an invite to download the app for the tenant. And that's where they pay the deposit and that's where they pay the first month rent. So they are already on it. They don't know any other way. So if they don't know, then they don't know.
Right. Well, it sounds like you've modernized more than just rent payments, right? So getting them started early in the application process, that's what they're accustomed to. They already have their login and then they're, I don't know, are they setting up auto pay and just kind of set it and forget it or,
Do
yeah.
yes, I do have quite a bit people who actually has on a auto pay, so that is also a great feature. Thanks for reminding. I forgot.
Yeah. It's a good
Yeah, it
benefit.
is a great feature that the tenant can set up a auto pay and it pays without them worrying about it.
Great. Well, yeah, it's great to hear that, you've got a new process for new residents moving in and you start the expectation early. So that way there'll be no more 3 to 4 month, learning curve for anyone. It'll be, easier and automated moving forward.
Correct. And once they move in, the maintenance request also is online. So as soon as they move in, and if there is something not working, whatnot, they can take a video, they can take a picture, they can upload it, they can put a statement. And from right there on the app, as soon as you get the email, you can send it to the people who's going to work on it or contact the tenant for more information from right there. So that is also a great feature.
That's great. Yeah, that's a great benefit there. And it's also a compounding effect. If you have a resident that hasn't really used the app much or the portal much, and they log in to submit a maintenance request, then they see, oh, I can also pay my rent here, right? Or vice versa, if they're logging in to pay their rent, they say, oh, I can do maintenance right here from the phone too. Great. Like now I don't have to text or call or email or knock on their door, right? So
Correct. Absolutely. And they can do it at any moment, and it does not have to be specific time, your office time. They can do it on their convenience.
True. Because what, sometimes the excuse if a resident's out of town and they're late on rent, or I'm sure you've heard, you could tell a lot of stories, right?
Bazillion. Every excuse in the book.
but if they can pay their rent from their phone from anywhere, right? It eliminates a lot of excuses. So, kind of curious, like, are you? I don't know if you have the stats on hand right now, but like, do you see less late payments with this new system, or do people still
Absolutely.
find a way to find excuses?
No, I definitely see very less late payments. Well, some of the business people might not like it because they count on that late fees
Yeah, true.
as an extra, but to me, it is easier. Because I don't want them to be late, and I don't have to go after them. I don't have to worry about it. It's already paid. So the few and far in between, I just have to go after.
Absolutely, but that's an ongoing thing in our industry here. So, well, again, very impressive story of getting such a high adoption rate and embracing change to give your residents a more convenient option and to help streamline things from the back end. Overall, what has this change meant for you and for your residents and for your business?
For my business, I have a lot more time. I do not have to worry about me making a mistake, bank making a mistake, me entering, me sitting there, me trying to figure out how to do accounts, how to send late notice. All that is my time that I can use to either travel, cook, listen, or buy more properties. That is the best feature I enjoyed. I did not think, I'm not going to tell my daughter that I do love it. But absolutely, that time is much appreciated. And it has helped me streamline the business quite a bit.
That's great to hear. Saving you time, and also the ability to scale, should you grow in the
Yes.
future. That's great to
Absolutely.
hear. Last question before we wrap up, can you tell us about your involvement with IRO and the IRO committee and beyond helping us with this session here?
Well, absolutely. I have been a part of IRO since 2021. I am a committee member. I have been for a few years. I am a committee liaison member. I go to different committees and the next gen. Also, I try to bring awareness of IRO members and IRO committee. What can we do for other committees and what other committees can do for us? As majority of here, everybody knows that IRO makes up quite a bit of percentages of a rental industry. If it wasn't for IRO, we would not have as big of a rental industry. So we want to make everybody aware that the small people, small IROs, face the same challenges as the big box rental management companies.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, thanks for sharing that your background and your partnership with IRO there. But you're right. I mean, some of these challenges we're talking about, like rent collection, this is relevant for IROs. This is also relevant for large companies that you all compete with as well, right? Everyone is trying to figure out better technology to improve resident experience to streamline operations. So it's really great you're being a thought leader in this space and sharing what's working well for you, because you're right. There's a lot of folks out there that could benefit.
Thank you for inviting me. Thank you for the opportunity to come and say my story.
Absolutely. And as we close here, Urvashi, thanks again for sharing your success story with us. And I think this is hopefully going to inspire some other members to either, rip off the Band-Aid and get online payments and the resident portal set up for the first time, like you did in 2020, or motivate others watching this that they have existing portals set up, but what else can they be doing technology-wise to streamline rent collection? How can they get their adoption rate to 99%, like you got it to? What
Persistent.
persistence. There we go. That's a good theme to close it on.
And I am here. If you would not mind sharing my contact info, I would love to help anybody who needs nudge in the direction.
Absolutely. We'll share our contact information on this session and would also encourage all the viewers today on the session to share your stories as well. What tips and tricks have you learned throughout, getting online payments set up? What do you wish you would have, known from the start? Please reach out to Urvashi or myself, or tag us on socials and share your story there. Want to thank everyone again for viewing the session. Urvashi, thanks again for sharing your story, and hope everyone has a great rest of the day.
Thank you so much, everybody.